speakers only hit the microphone, so when we have souls up there, it's about 8 times louder than the band here behind the bounty area. We're missing a trombone, but we probably need to go ahead and start anyway, so we're not going to keep everything too late.
Thank you. In Middell Schools, we're fortunate and blessed to have a wonderful administration, both here at Del City High School and of the Middell Public Schools as a whole. I'm not totally sure who's here, so I'm going to go ahead and announce them all, and those that are present can stand and be recognized. The superintendent of Middell Public Schools is Dr. Cheryl Steele. Director of Personnel for Middell Public Schools, she usually attends our concerts. I haven't seen whether or not she was here tonight, but that's Marie Davis. Principal of Del City High School, Ms. Annette Nanqua. The senior principal of Del City High School is Mr. Dave Holland. Junior principal of Del City High School is Mr. Al Nichols. And the sophomore principal is Ms. Gina Peck. I hate to do it, but I'm going to have to turn the stage over to Mr. Gooder now for the next two songs.
We're real pleased. Again, this year we had so many souls to actually improv the scales and the chords, and one of the judges at Judge in St. Louis came up and really acknowledged how many of them there were and how much she enjoyed all the different solos. And the jazz band, one of the outstanding jazz band there, was the highest total point score of the entire festival. They were all band, orchestras, and choruses, and the whole thing. And this next tune is Barbra Streisand number. All of you probably have heard this. It's People, and it features our lead trombone, Jeremy Rudd.
Thank you.
person down here somewhere. We're going to come down. There it is. We're going to give the our outstanding jazz awards right now. And each year we give one or two of those, and depending on what we have. And we've been really blessed to give us some outstanding seniors that have really done a marvelous job for us all these years. And we've got two to give tonight, and that is to David Ramsey and Mona Rowe. If you guys will sit up here. Just turned out this evening that the tunes are mostly on the clarinet for on the improv, but she does a marvelous job on the alto sax and the improv too. And they both have been outstanding for us. And we would definitely miss their talent and their commitment to the band program. Thanks. Students arranged by Sam Nestico and his Magic Fleet. Okay, features on this, Jonathan Graham again on the tenor. Joey Wilson, we haven't mentioned tonight on the trap set. He's got a really good part coming out. Greg on the piano, show a solo, and David again on the bass. It's just flying back there. Thank you.
I give him another round of hands?
Thank you.
In the movie Titanic, there is a lot of good music. What we're going to play for you tonight is one of the more obscure things within the movie, but it's been a lot of fun to play, and I think you'll really enjoy it. It's called An Irish Party in Third Class. Before we play our next piece, I wanted to come out and kind of explain to you what the piece is about. It's an extremely emotional, strong piece that when you don't really understand what it's about, it sounds kind of bizarre. But what the piece is, it's entitled, Do Not Go Gentle Into That Good Night. And it's based on a poem of the same name. And the author of this poem had a daughter that had a terminal illness that eventually was going to kill her. And obviously he loved her, and he knew that she had a lot to offer this world. So his poem is urging her to fight against the death that was taking over her body and cling to life, because there were a lot of beautiful things in life that she had to offer. So you'll hear some spots in this. It almost sounds like we're warming up rather than actually playing an actual piece of music. But that's the conflict of this person, is they fight against death. So I think you'll really enjoy this piece. It's entitled, Do Not Go Gentle Into That Good Night.
Thank you. Thank you.
say goodbye to some people who have been with me, some of them, 7 years. And that's not the easiest thing to do. But they're a very special group of people that we will miss. Each year, we select one senior to be the recipient of the John Philip Sousa Award for Band. Many bands around the country give out this award. It's an extremely special award. I know that our plaque that stays on the wall, people go by and look just to see whose names are on it from the past. It's kind of a special honor to be selected as the John Philip Sousa winner for the senior year. This is an award that only goes to seniors. Excuse me, I can't talk at that last song. But it's given for their service to band over the 3 years they're with us. So it's not just what they do their senior year. It's the solos and ensembles they play, the honor bands they participate in, and that kind of thing. I know you're tired of hearing me talk, so let me just announce who the winner is this year. The John Philip Sousa Award for, what is this year, 2000, is Harry Taggart. Seniors graduating is that you lose their parents right along with them. And we're very close, obviously. Many of you all spend many hours in our concession stands working. And like I said, it's hard to say goodbye to some very special people. So, Kathy Rudd, would you please come forward? She told me that before she left, that this band would have new uniforms and they would have a truck. Today, we have new uniforms and a truck. And a lot of that is due to her. So I made up a little plaque to give Kathy so she will remember us. I know we'll still see her around, probably not as frequently as what we have in the past, but I'm sure we'll still see her around. But I made a plaque, it's got a picture of us, and below it says, Kathy Rudd, we love you, thanks for being there for us. Del City High School Band, 1993 to 2000. Thank you.
deep in the jungle of ancient Africa. A hermit sat thinking about big and little, but suddenly he saw a tiny mouse about to be snatched up by a large black crow. He hurried to help the poor little animal. He teared the mouse from the crow's greedy beak and carried him off to the hut in the jungle, where he confronted him with milk and grains thrice. But suddenly, look! A cat came to the hut with whiskers and tail held high. But the hermit was mighty at magic as well as a predator. When he saw the dangerous cat threatening his little pet, he quickly changed the mouse into a stout cat. But that night, while the hermit was sleeping in his straw hut, a dog barked in the jungle. Poor cat ran to hide under the hermit's bed. The hermit wasted no time in thinking about how big or so big. So he changed the cat into a big dog. Woof. Not long after that, a hungry mean tiger was prowling in the jungle and suddenly leaped on the dog. Fortunately, the hermit was nearby, and with a gesture, he changed the dog into a handsome, royal tiger. Imagine the pride of that tiger, all day long walking about the dangerous jungle, proud over all of the helpless animals. The hermit missed nothing of all of this pride and confronted the beast. "Well, that to me," he said to the tiger, "you would be a helpless little mouse. That is, if you were still alive. There was no need, there is no need, to give yourself such airs." The tiger felt offended and humiliated. He forgot all the good the hermit had did for him. "No one shall tell me that I was once a mouse. I will kill him." But the hermit read the tiger's mind. "You are ungrateful. Go back to the forest and be a mouse again." So the proud and handsome royal tiger turned back into a humble, frightened little mouse and ran back off into a forest, and he wasn't ever seen again. And the hermit sat thinking about big and little. I have five things I want you to remember before you leave here today. Number one, always say thank you to someone whenever they do something good for you. Showing ungratefulness can only damage yourself and your reputation. Never take anything nor anyone for granted. Number three, do unto others as you would have them to do unto you. And number four, the tiger thought he was bigger, stronger, and more handsome than all of the other animals in the jungle. But because of his pride, ungratefulness, and his arrogance, the old man turned him back into a frightened, humble little mouse. So as a result, he was disciplined by being transformed back into the mouse. And number five, it doesn't matter if you're African American, white, Asian, Hispanic, or Native American. Every color is a beautiful color. Yes, there are cultural differences among our nationalities, but that does not mean one race is better than another. African music is a form of expression and freedom. Drumming is one of the most forms of expression that Africans use in order to express their emotional and spiritual feeling. Also, clapping, dancing, and singing is another important part of the African culture. The founders of the drum, or creators of the first drum known as the Bassa drum,
me introduce myself. My name is Antonio Banderas. I have traveled from far to play this song for you tonight. Hope you like it. Thank you. Now I'm really out of breath. We got one more song. This is, I guess, a little bit more serious than what I just came out here and did. It's going to be kind of funny to be up here directing this and semi-Zorro here. But this is a wonderful country we're from, and our program tonight is kind of containing music that can be heard around the world. And all those cultures are combined into ours. So I think it's only fitting that we end this concert with America the Beautiful. Great summer, and we'll be back again next year.